In the 90s, hip-hop became more and more the thing in the music industry. Hip-hop started to become mainstream. Pop acts, R&B acts wanted to feature rap artists in their music because everybody wanted a type of realness in their music. Hip-hop became a whole movement and changed people's life, to good and to bad. We had artists who cursed all day, all night long in all of the songs, and on the other side we had a new movement of people who wanted to take hip-hop to the next level with Christian message. They wanted to use hip-hop as a positive tool, and they wanted to share the experience with Christ to their music and save people's life. People who are not affiliated with Christian hip-hop thinks always of cringe rappers who are not talented, who cannot rap, who said after every 5 or 10 seconds Jesus, people who don't have enough life experience, people who live in the bubble world, they are always happy and had never negative experience in life. That's the type of conception that some people have when it comes to Christian hip-hop. And of course, there are some rappers or a lot of rappers in the past who cannot rap, but they try to be rappers in the Christian world, but also we have that mainstream too. The Gospel Gangsterz were formed in the 90s and they came from Los Angeles. The group consists group members Mr. Solo, who created the group, DJ Dove, TikTok, and Chille Baby. Before they became a Christian group, they were affiliated with gangs, brutality, sex, drugs, alcohol, gunshots, and stuff like that. They were living the gangster life. The group founder, Mr. Solo, became a Christian after he almost died in a gang-related shooting. After that, he realized he has to change his life because there was a higher power which protected him. So he started to get more and more connected with the Word of God. And during that time, God was using him and started to change something in him. And he started to feel the need to start to minister to other people and to bring people near to God. He wanted to focus on people who came up from the hood, from the ghetto, who grew up like him. And his mission was to become a light for the people who are in the darkness. At that time, hip-hop was popping, and he realized the best way to reach those people is when I start to do music. Because I love music, I feel music, and I can share this music with people. So he created his group. And the best music out there is real music. He came up from the ghetto world. He has stories to tell. So he started to record music with his group. In 1994, they released their first solo album, Gang Affiliated. They were one of the first hip-hop Christian groups who were out there. And people in the underground world started to listen to their music. It was not that mainstream at that time, because people on TV loved cursing rappers. So the music sounded too positive for them. For Christian and gospel radio stations, it was too ghetto, and they did not know in which category this type of music will fit in their catalog. So they did not play the music because for them it was too ghetto, it was too street. And a little reminder, at that time nobody had Instagram, nobody had Facebook, social media was not there, YouTube was not there. So at that time you had just the opportunities to promote that on the streets. So they were building their fan base from the underground. At that time, they were signed by a small independent label, Holy Terror Records. Some of the Christians out there were questioning their faith because they were using in a lot of their songs the word nigger. After the first album, DJ Dove decided to leave the group. In 1995, they released their second album, Do or Die. They continued to build their fan base and to perform on different locations. In 1999, they released their third album, I Can See Clearly Now. For this album, they signed a new record deal with the label Be Right Records. And this time things started to level up for them because they received their first Grammy nomination in the category Best Rock Gospel Album. All the hard work they put in before started to pay off. Other releases from the group included The Exodus, that came out in 2002, All Mixed Up in 2003, The Flute in 2006, Streets Discipline in 2011, and their final album Defenders of the Faith in 2013. In 2003, TikTok, one of the members, decided to leave the group, and his bandmates gave him the blessings, so they decided to move on as a duo. After a while, it was reported that TikTok was involved in a gun shooting and he had been arrested. For his ex-groupmates, it was a shock because they never thought that TikTok will go back into the hood life that he came up before. Mr. Solo said in some of the interviews that when he met TikTok, he was really into God and ministry, and he wanted to change people's life who are living the gangster life and wanted to be affiliated with drugs, gangs, and alcohol. It hurt them deeply, but they mentioned after TikTok left the group, they didn't talk to him anymore that much, and they were not in contact with him anymore. And I know some people always ask why people and groups don't reach out to the ex-bandmates because they were like family, they spent so much time together. But hey, you can just help someone who wants to be in contact with you. And sometimes in groups it's like you spend so much time together and sometimes you want to back up and to find your own identity without the group. That's the reason why some of those people don't want to be in contact for a while with their ex-group mates. So the group moved on without him and they had a lot to do and he moved on with his life.
Funny how I started ghetto when poverty stricken. Now whoever looks upon my medallion, I'd be spitting a dollar forgiven. I stay bumping ride with the Christians, that's why I'm still living. To the homies died in position, the sky has a ribbon. I think every time I be spitting, this life that we living. I need be to die as a Christian, that's God to forgive him. When the shells from the nine hit him, I cry cause I miss him. It's too hard to try to forget him, my ride be sipping. And since the other side be tripping, whoever the angels don't stop, the 45 forget him. And I have a rhythm, came to step outside of tradition, to ride is my mission. And we could lie with religion, divide and collision. And before I die in the prison, I find me a system. Before child, they find out I'm missing, these guys are forbidden. I ignore and try not to listen, but why is you dissing? You can die for the lie you spitting, divide by division. Only few inside my division, the riders is Christian. Who would rather die than to diss him? I'm a gangster. Can't back to the riders all around the world.
Some people started to critique the group because they thought the group were operated the same way TikTok did. One foot in, one foot out. It's always the same story, they tried to make them look like hypocrites. But the group wanted clearly to move on with the vision that God gave them and they did not let people stop them from that.
Got smoked, he broke all the yokes and I'm still low. I know it's tricky seeing the Christian belling dickies, but I never stop banging, just change my gang. I got a stomp in my gangster boots, cause the boys in the hood wouldn't hear me in a silk suit. No life so cameras, give me some acting with a fat groom. My solo creep like a thief on a jack move. What's the information on my gang affiliation? Yo, my Bible's in my waist. There's no colors on the brother cause my rags go, but I'm still low, so I gotta get my sack on. So don't trip when you see me in a pool pit. It's like I'm sat with a Mazak in a full clip. I pull quick when God's anointed. If my Bible good. You catch your verses like a hollow point. Cause Mr. Solo's in the house with the gangster walk. That's how the gangsters talk. Cause I'm gangster talk. Cause as a youngster in LA being brought up, doing anything thought up. Cause I was caught up like the rapture. Note that my mind was fractured. Cause the system and the ways of my neighborhood was backwards. They call me cool when I blast with a 380. Did Jesus save me? Now they call me crazy. But I'm smarter. I come to a little harder. Pack a nine for those thinking of making me a martyr. Me wrestle against the flesh.
I'm not saying that.
But running up on me, devil.
I ain't playing that.
You heard about the crew and tried to drown. But forget the case.
During their career, they worked with huge gospel artists like Kirk Franklin, A1 Swift, CMC's and Mary Mary. In May 2020, it was reported that Mr. Solo died. It was sad because he did a lot for Christian hip hop and his mission was always to reach the next generation through his music and through his art and to make people to come to Jesus, especially people who live in the ghettos who don't have hope, people who live in the gangster life, drugs, sex, alcohol. He did a lot for Christian hip hop, even if people don't mention that often enough. Alongside with Grits and some other hip hop acts, the Gospel Gangsterz open a lot of doors for a lot of musicians in today's world. I even think they inspired some of the mainstream artists out there. I hope you liked the video, and yes, leave me a thumb up, leave me a comment, subscribe to the channel to not miss any other videos. And if you want to know what happened to the legendary Christian hip hop group Grits, then click now on the next video and watch it. We see each other next time. Bye.